Good morning, everybody. Hello, thanks for tuning in. Thanks for spending your Friday morning dancing with me. It's Friday, July 23rd. We're going to do three fun dances, one at a time, and then at the end, hopefully we have time to put them all together and get a nice good workout. The first one is crazy fast, okay? So, but it's very, very easy. So we're gonna start with a salsa, a bachata, and then a samba. So the first one has a 64 count intro, but we're gonna use 32 counts of that as its own choreography. So I'll get to that at the very end. Let's just do the basic dance first. 32 counts, four walls, beginner level, and no tags and no restarts. So we're gonna start with weight on our left foot. I'll do this facing you so you can see what I'm doing. Starting with your weight supported on your left foot, we're gonna tap our right foot forward and across and then tap to the side. Okay, so one, two, and tap means no weight. Then we do a botafogo, which is step, press, replace the weight. Okay, so starting with your weight on your left, you're tapping your right foot forward, side, step forward right, pressing left to side on the ball of the foot only to come back. If the botafogo is a problem, do a cross point. I'm going to show you how to make this dance easier at the end, okay? Like, it's very, very fast. We can slow it down a little bit by taking up the syncopation. But here we're going to do one, two, three, and four. And then the same thing with the other foot, five, six, seven, and eight. Okay, to simplify that, you can do cross points. So you could dance point, point, step, point, 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 step, point. The count, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. All right, so we've said this before, three steps gets you the same place as one step. You might as well, if you want to simplify, okay, because it is going to be pretty fast. All right, so I'm going to dance the botafogo. So I'm going to dance part one. One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, and eight. Part two, we're free on your right foot. We're going to do a cross chasse, or otherwise known as a traveling volta to our left. You're standing on your left foot. You're going to bring your right foot across. Release the back heel, step a small step, across, a small step, and across, a small step, and across. Why do I say small step? Because of the speed. You're almost going to have no time at all. Basically, it's going to be cross and cross and cross and cross. Okay, can we practice that? Right foot in front, bent knees, release that heel of the left foot, and cross and cross and cross and cross. Ending with your knees flexed, your weight fully over your right foot, and you're going to bring your left foot in front and do the same thing, traveling bolted to your right. Release that right heel right away. Cross and cross and cross and cross. Please remember to cross in front. If you cross behind, it's going to be trouble, okay? You're going to get twisted. So part two is a traveling volta, bringing your right foot in front. Cross and cross and cross and cross, and bring your left foot in front, cross and across and across and across. All right, good. Let's put one and two together. At one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, and eight. One and two and three and four, five and six and seven and eight. Part three, we do a jazz box with a cross, okay? So, you see my feet. I'm gonna start with my weight is on my left. I'm gonna bring my right foot across my left, releasing the back heel. Take a step back, take a step to the side, and bring your left foot forward and across. So we're gonna hit all four corners. Corner one, corner two, corner three, corner four. We do that twice. On the second one, we make one quarter turn to our right. So it looks like this. Across, back, side, forward. Across, back, you turn an eighth. Side, you turn another eighth, forward. So split the turn in little bits and it will be much easier, okay? So, or you can just turn the whole quarter over both box steps if you like. You don't have to do one with no turn. You can just, final product, you must be one quarter to your right. So part three, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. You might have noticed I do a little swivel. All right, why? Because it's fun. So I'm standing on my left foot. I swivel that foot to the left. I step back. I swiveled my right foot. I step to the side and I swivel as I step. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Just to get a little salsa kind of feel. Okay, not necessary to do, of course. Let's put 1, 2, and 3 together. At 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're at 3 o'clock. We're gonna do a grapevine. I'll dance that this way. We'll do a grapevine to our right, side to the right, back on the left, side to the right, tap, or just point. At speed, you might just wanna point. I think that's what I'm gonna do, all right? So I'm gonna end up doing side, behind, side, tap. And see, I did a little wind up because I'm gonna turn on my next grapevine, one full turn to my left. So I'm gonna step forward on the left foot, I turned a quarter. I'm gonna step to the side on my right, I turn another quarter. I'm gonna use my right foot, right leg, a little pressure to push, turning this foot, turning my right foot, and then you notice my left foot goes under my body and I end up to the side, maybe with a tap, maybe not, okay? So what I don't want you to do when you turn is to try to turn your body without turning your foot, okay? Or stopping anything. I need you to dance. Step, spin, step, tap, okay? I spin from your foot. Step, turn from my left, turn from my right. Okay, one more time. Step, 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 tap, or not. Maybe not, okay? So, bottom line, when you're doing a turn, turn from your feet. Turn from your feet before you step. Okay, don't try to go somewhere like this. You have, if I want to go that way on this foot, I have to turn first, then I can step. Otherwise, you get locked up. Your legs get all twisted. You might hurt your knee. You might hurt your hip. Don't want you to hurt anything. All right, so part four is going to be facing 3 o'clock, but I'll dance it this way. We do a side grapevine, right foot, right, left, right, left, right, left. And we're back to the beginning, which was tap, tap, go to fogo. So let's do the whole thing, and then we'll try, oh, then I have to do part A, all right? So this is actually part B. So we start again, 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and start again. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That was still too slow. All right, good. Part A, which is the first 32 count intro. Okay, so it's a 64 count intro. We're gonna let 32 counts go, and then we start with this basic. It might be really crazy, too hard, but it gives you a chance to get accustomed to the speed of the music, okay? So the very beginning, 32 counts, I'm gonna call it part A, starts with a basic mambo, basic mambo forward and back, and then a basic side and side. So we dance right foot forward, rock, step, back on the left, forward on the right, back on the left. Everybody knows a basic mambo. Let's do it again. rock, replace, step back, replace, step forward. Rock, replace, step back, replace, step forward. So it's a rock step, meaning you don't move the other foot. So if I'm forward on my right, my left foot stays in place. If I'm back on my left, my right foot stays in place. The count, quick, quick, slow, quick, quick, slow. Or one and two, three and four. One and two, three and four. Okay, let's do it. And then we go to the side. One and two, three and four, five and six, seven to the side. One and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. Those are called cucarachas. Again, don't move your supporting foot. We move to the right and come back, the left and come back. Right and come back, left and come back. Keep the steps basically kind of small. Don't worry about how far you're going. Keep them small. And again, at speed, you're going to want to keep it small. So part three of part A, a side step, side together, side, and side together, side tap. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Or actually the count is one and two and three and four. When you get to four, on that end, we're going to turn a half a turn to your left. Looks like this. Side together, side, tap, and turn. Side together, side, tap, and turn. Side together, side, tap, side together, side, out, out, in, in. I might have turned wrong. Let me do that again with the count. One and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight and. One and two, three and four, five, six, seven, eight. All right. Do it again. Side together, side. Side together, turn. Side together, side. Side together, turn. Side together, side. Side together, side. Out, out, in, in. Step diagonally out right, diagonally out left. Bring it back to the center. Close your feet, change weight. Ready to start our dance. All right, so I'm going to do part A after 32 counts. And then part B for the rest of the dance. We don't repeat this again, all right? So just for me, I found this was really, 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 really fast. So those side steps might be, if they cause you trouble, then just do the basic forward and back and wait until we get into our beginning of our dance. You can just do this, a one and two, three and four, and a one and two, three and four, and a one and two, three and four, and a one and two, three and again, one and two. While we're doing side steps, you just go back to that basic forward and back. Absolutely good. All we're trying to do is spend the time without just standing there waiting for the beginning of the dance, right? So we're just going to try to move a little bit, get used to the speed of the music, and then we're ready to start. So I'm going to do part A and B together. Okay, ready? Ready? And. One and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. One and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. One and two and three and four and five and six and seven and eight and one and two, three and four and five, six, basic dance. One, two, three and four, five, six, seven and volta. One and two and three and four, five and six and seven and a box. One, two, three, four, five, six. Grapevine. One, two, three, four, and turn six. Start again. One, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, and eight. One and two and three and four and five and six and seven and box. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Grapevine. One, two, three, four. Turn one more time and one. Botafogo. Two. Botafogo. Volta. Volta, and a box, and a box. Grapevine, one, two, three. Grapevine with the turn. You can always leave out the turn. You can do grapevine, grapevine without the turn. I'm going to show you how to slow it down. All right. So the beginning is one, two, three, and four, five, six, seven, and eight. You can easily dance One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. The traveling volta, one and two and three and four, you can change to one, two, three, four. Sorry, is that right? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Okay, let's do that slow. Cross and cross, cross and cross. And then you're going to have to do the rest on time. The rest is single timing, you should be okay. All right, so the slower version could be one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. 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 You can always leave out the turn. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four. That was my knee that just gave out. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. That's a simpler version. Even that is going to be fast. I'm already pooped. All right, so I'm going to put the music on. Are we ready? Are we ready? Let me see if anybody's not ready. Want to do it again? No, no messages. All right, so that tells me you're ready to do it to music. Let's just do our best. No tags, no restarts. And it's a great way for us to warm up, okay? The next one is slow. This dance is called Salsa Monica and the choreographer Masna Taufik. All right, the music is Indonesia 6. It's very nice. Here we go. Salsa Monica. Hey, oh, hey, hey, oh, hey, oh, hey, oh, hey, oh. Thank you. Time to stop it for the next dance. All right, so that warmed us up. You might need a drink. Thanks for sticking with that. I love it because of the speed. And it's actually not a hard dance, but fast, so should have got your heart going. I hope so. Great way to start the day. Now we're going to do a bachata. Yes, we've heard that music before. We've used that before, but this one is also a beginner. I think it's a beginner or a low improver. Phrase improver. And it's called Amare Bachata. Amare Bachata by Nelly Wahyuni. All right, so fabulous 64 count, but don't let that discourage you. It's really 32 count with an extra little bit a couple of times, okay? So four walls and phrased. Let's learn the basic part of the dance. It's most of the dance, okay? Very basic, easy bachata. We're gonna start with our weight on our left foot. We're moving basic to the side, right, close left to right, right, and tap with a little hip bump, which is a basic bachata action, all right? So we dance right, left, right, a little hip lift, and then the same thing, but to our left, side together, side with a little lift. All right, let's do that with a count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Part two is what we call a K step. We're going to make the K shape of, there's the stick, we're going to make that shape, okay? So we're going to step, you tap with your right, the free on your right, you're going to go diagonally forward with the right, tapping left to right, diagonally back with the left, tap right to left, diagonally back with the right, tap left to right, and diagonally forward with the left, tap right to left. It sounded way more complicated than it was. We dance. Diagonal, tap, back, tap, forward, tap. And if possible, we add that little hip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All right, let's put 1 and 2 together. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're going to dance like a grapevine, but instead of going behind, we're going to dance in front. And at the end, we do a little tap. So, but we're not making it a foxtrot grapevine, we're making it a bachata grapevine. So if I'm facing forward, I ended up here, I'm facing forward. I'm going to do a little turn to my left as I step forward, then to step to the side, then I'm going to step back with a little turn again, but this time to my right, and then the tap will be this way, okay, with a little tap and a hip bump. So I'm going to dance 1, 2, 3, 4, and then same thing other side, step right, left with a tap and a hip bump. All right, this is a bachata interpretation of a weave. I'll show you a foxtrot weave would be forward, side, back, point, forward, side, back, point. So that's perfectly okay, but you might feel to do a bachata style, which is not this big point to the side, but 1, 2, 3 with a tap, 5, 6, 7 with a tap, and a hip lift. That's how I'm gonna dance it. So let's put part 1, 2, and 3 together. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Across, two, three, four, across, six, seven, eight. And the last part is a box step, just like we did, except we're going to close our feet on the first one instead of passing. So on the first one, we only hit the three corners. Right foot across, left foot back, right foot to side, left foot closes to right. If you go forward, fine, but it's closed. And then we do the same thing, but turn it. This time, we end with a forward step. Okay? Does it really matter? No. Just be comfortable. Okay? Do what your feet want to do. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Or eight. Okay? All right? Nobody is reporting us to the dance police. All right. And that's the whole dance. Let's do it again. All right. From the top, all four pieces. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. A K step and a back and a forward. And across, two, three, tap, across, two, three, tap, a box, two, three, four, a box, six, seven. Again, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Part three. Sorry, on the third wall, which would be facing 6 o'clock, and again on the sixth wall, which will be facing 3 o'clock. We have part B. Part B looks like this. And by the way, it's really obvious in the music. There's two times in the dance where he sings very differently. He starts with this whoa thing happening. When he says whoa, we do this part B, and it's only twice, and it's so clearly obvious. It's gonna start with a side step, side together, side tap. And then that turn that we just did in the last dance, turn, six, seven with a tap. All right? If you miss the turn and you see me do it, then you know, like it starts the same as part A, but if I did the turn and you didn't do the turn, you know we're into part B. All right? So it's not a big deal if you miss the turn. So side together, side tap, turn, six, seven, eight. Now we're going to do cross point forward. Forward tap. Okay, with a little hip bump. Cross point, and a rock forward and back. With your right foot, rock forward and back, replace. Okay, so I'm gonna do that from the side. So you see where we are. This would be wall six. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Cross, two, three, four, rock, six, seven, eight. Okay, good. Then we walk forward, right foot, right, left, right, tap with a hip bump, and back, two, three, tap. So the foot, right, left, right, tap, because you're going to use left, left, right, left, tap. Again, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. You need to be free on your right foot. Did we do it? Let me do it from this side. This is better. See my left foot. And right, two, three, tap. Left, two, three, tap. Last part, two paddle steps with a hula hoop action and circling our hips counterclockwise and a half a turn overall, so a quarter plus a quarter. So you dance forward, 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 and back, back, back. From here, forward on the right, turn a quarter. Forward on the left, turn a quarter. And then just close right to left, transfer the weight, and march. Just march on the spot. One, two, three, four, because you need to be free to start your right foot. So the last part, part four of part B, is forward, forward, together, and march, march. Ready to start again with part A, and that's the dance, okay? So let's do part A, for wall one and two, and then part B for wall three, and part A again for wall four, just so you know what's happening. All right, so here we go. We're going to do the basic part A. Side together, side, side together, side. K step, forward and back and back, and a weave, and across, side, back, tap, across, side, back, and a box, two, three, four, a box, six, and repeat. Side together, side, side together, side. K step, back and forward, and across, side, back, across, side, back, and a box, two, three, four, turning. Here is part B. Side together, side with a turn. Together, step, and across once, cross twice, rocking chair. Run, 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 or walk, walk, walk. A paddle, and on the spot. And part A, K step, and a weave, and across, two, three, four, across, six, seven, and a box, two, three, four, back to the beginning again, right? So that becomes wall four. Well, that doesn't make any sense. That was wall three. This is wall four, five, six, seven, eight. I must have made a mistake. No, I didn't. I made it correct. So wall three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Yeah, wall nine. So I said six. I don't know what was happening to me. All right, so wall three and wall nine will be, all you have to know is this. The first time we hit 6 o'clock, wall part B, and then we go around. And the next time we hit 3 o'clock is wall B again. All right, so we're ready for music? I think we are. How are we doing for time? We're doing really well. I could actually dance it one more time. Let me just dance it one more time because I feel like I rushed you. All right, ready? To the side. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. K step and back and forward. Across, side, back, a box and a box. Part B, I'm gonna dance the first part B this way. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, cross point, rocking chair. Walk forward, one, two, three, walk back, back, two, three, and a paddle, and on the spot, start to the beginning. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, K step, I think we're good. Five, six, seven, and across, side, back, across, and together, and across, across. I think that was better, right? Let's put the music on. Here we go. 32 count intro. The music. Lamento Boliviano. Ay,
quieren agitar, necesitan agitar. Son como una roca, palabras con mi boca me habituan a engordar. Un poco más allá, yo quiero estar tranquilo. Es mi situación, una desolación. Son como un lamento boliviano que un día empezó. No va a terminar, ya nadie hace daño.
Por favor.
I don't mess you up. I left part out. Did you notice? Maybe you didn't notice. Sorry. Thinking about my daughter coming tonight. First time in almost 2 years. Yay! Today is a very happy, happy day. So we're going to celebrate with a fantastic samba now. Try not to get distracted by the fact that my daughter is coming. Sorry. All right. Our last one is a samba. We have one basic restart with a little trick in the middle, all right? But otherwise, it's four walls and a 32 count, okay? It is, I always save the hardest one for last, but it's not hard. It's not hard, all right? So this one is in the top 10 around the world at the moment, so I thought you might like it. It's nice. All right, the music is awesome. All right, we're going to start with, it's a basic samba with international style samba steps. So we're going to start with a whisk to our right, a side step, landing on your right foot, bend that knee to absorb your weight, crossing your right and your left foot behind on the ball of the foot only, and replace. And then do the same thing the other side. You're going to land ball to flat, ball, flat. So one and two. Three and four. Two walks forward, walk right, walk left. With a rock and a turn, step forward right, pivoting on your left foot. Keep turning so that you end up with your weight on your right foot, but turned 3/4 to your left. So let me do that last part again. You're going to step forward on your right. It's a spot turn, turning from your right to your left. Keep turning now on your left foot as you step to the side. Remember what we said last dance, two dances ago? Always turn from your standing foot before you move, okay? Don't try to move and not turn, all right? Especially if you're going backwards. So we are here. Part A looks like this. Side, cross behind, side, cross behind. Walk right, walk left. Forward, right, left, right. 3/4 turn to your left. Let's do it with the count. And one and two, three and four, five, six, seven and eight. Ending with your weight fully over your right. Now, because of the speed, it's not that fast. It's not as fast as the first one. But because of the speed, when you step forward on your right foot, you don't need to place that heel on the floor.
you can just do press and side, okay? Ball foot, ball to flat. You don't need to get all the way in it and push yourself off because there won't be time. It's not a true cha-cha or rumba style squat turn. It's a samba style, which is press and side. You see that? I'll do it from here. Press and side. Okay? Three quarters of a turn. And you know three quarters, wherever you ended up, just add a quarter different. So if I'm here, that's my point. If I'm here, three quarters would be here. Okay? So that's probably the hardest part of the whole dance. All right, so let's do from the beginning. We do a whisk, two walks, and I'm gonna call it a, what should I call that? I don't know. A rock turn, all right? Because we're rocking and we're turning. All right, so a one and two, a three and a four, and five, six, seven, and eight. Standing facing 3 o'clock, weight is over your right foot. That's part one. Part two. Now, we're gonna dance again. We're standing on that foot already. It's like a wish, but it's actually a cumbia style step. We're gonna rock back and side. So it's the same as the beginning, except the beginning was side and back. Now it's back and side, into two portafolios, one on the left and one on the right. And of course, you can replace that with a cross point. All right, so part two looks like this, one and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. Just to go over portafolio, starting with the left, forward left, press right to side, ball of foot only, replace the weight to a flat left foot, stepping right, ball to flat, press left to side, replace weight to right. Okay, so part, let's do part one and two together. Ready? And a one and two, three and a four, and five, six, seven, and eight, one and two, three and four, portafolio once, portafolio twice. Part three, a rock step to another rock step to a back taps. I'm going to dance it this way. I'm going to rock forward, rock, replace, step back. Okay? One and two. Now step back on the right, rock, and step again. So they call that an anchor step. So you're going to rock, rock, step, rock, rock, step. Back and back. Ending with your weight over your right. Okay, the count. One and two, three and four. Then, bringing your left foot, step tap, step tap, step tap, step tap. You're not tapping to close, you're just tapping the front foot in front. So, one and two, three and four, and five and six, and seven and eight. Okay, that is fast, very, very fast. Rock, rock, step, rock, rock, step, and tap, and tap, and tap, and tap. Okay, if you want to practice a hip action, when you do your tap, you're going to shove that hip forward a little bit. It's not easy to do, all right? One and two, three and four, and five and six, and seven and eight. Using the beat, the actual beat, as the push, all right? That is completely not necessary. You do not need to do that, but I'm gonna try it because I want the exercise, I want the practice, but it's just basically to simplify. One and two, anchor, step, and tap, and tap, and tap, and tap. Perfectly beautiful. You're making your feet the star of that step. One more time. One and two, three and four, and five and six, and seven and eight. Just go back with your knees flexed, okay? And the accent will be your feet. If you do it the other way, one and two, three and four, and five and six, and seven and eight, your hip is the star. So you decide. It can be one or the other, all right? Good. So let's dance part 1, 2, and 3. And that will be dance, let's put 1, 2, and 3 together. Ready? Whisk to start and. A 1 and 2, 3 and a 4 and a 5 and a 6 and a 7 and 8. 1 and 2, 3 botafogos, 5 and 6, 7 and 8. Rock, step and step and step and back and back and back and back. Part 4. We dance the basic. You ended up with your weight on your right, but your left foot tapped forward. You're just going to go forward, forward left into a ball to flat. Bring your feet together, change weight. You see what I did? Watch my feet. Step, change weight. Go back, back, change weight. So 1 and 2, 3 and a 4. And you see that I keep my knees flexed. Step and step. From here, the second half of part 4, we're going to do the paddle, but at speed. It's not this hip, it's a present point. Starting facing, you'll actually be this way, starting facing 3 o'clock. The first point is going to be at 6 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 12 o'clock, back to where you were, okay? So normally when we do that step, the first one is forward, but in this case, the first one is forward with a turn. That's also a little hard to do. It doesn't matter where you go. You know you need to be here. So it needs to be one full turn. So let's dance part 3. We dance 1 and 2, 3 and 4 and 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7. Eight. Just use your right foot as the center, point, 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 close. As long as you get one full turn, it doesn't matter if you start. If you can, a quarter plus a quarter plus a quarter plus a quarter is perfect. If you started here, you have to do, maybe you did a quarter plus a quarter plus, sorry, but I don't know what I did. I have to be here. So I did 1, 2, 3. I had to do a half at the end. It doesn't matter. End up facing where you started on part 3. Okay, let's put the whole thing together. And right from the beginning. A 1 and 2, 3 and a 4 and 5, 6, 7 and 8. 1 and 2, 3 and 4 botafogos, 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6 and 7 and 8. 1 and 2, 3 and 4. 5 and 6 and 7, 8. Back to the beginning. 1 and 2, 3 and a 4. And walk, walk, press and step. Back and back. 2 botafogos, botafogos. Rock, step, rock, back and tap and tap and tap and tap. Forward on the left, back on the right. Paddle, 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 close. This is wall 3. We have a restart on wall 3. We're going to dance the first 14 counts, and then we're going to do a twist turn, one full turn. So I'm going to show you what we do. From the beginning, 1 and 2, 3 and 4, 5, 6. This doesn't change. 7 and 8. 1 and 2, 3 and 4. 1 botafogo, 5 and 6. That's 14 counts. You would normally do a botafogo on your right foot. I'm going to do it this way. You did 5 and 6. Normally it would be 7 and 8. On wall 3, we dance 5 and 6. Cross your right foot in front. Okay. 7. And on 8, untwist and step. Okay. So 5 and 6, 7, 8. Because you need to start 1 and 2. All right, I understand that's hard. I found an easier way. So just call that a twister. And I also found it's easier if you go on your heel, if you make that like a forward step, whatever. Okay, I know that looks pretty, but I find this is good. Anyways, one full turn. Don't look at the floor while you're turning. But also, it's the same as if you did a spot turn. You know, what's the difference? So if I'm doing 5 and 6, I want to turn 7 and 8 through the tap, ready to go again. So that works as well. So it's a press, replace, and tap, staying on your left foot. That's easier than one full turn.
right? Anyway, it only happens that once, and we will be facing 9 o'clock when it happens. So it's from wall three, okay? So let's go through all together. Wall, let's start wall two, wall three, and wall four. Ready? This is wall two, facing 3 o'clock. Got it? All right, ready? 3 o'clock, and a one and two, three and a four, and five, six, seven, and eight. One and two, three and four, five and six, seven and a rock. One and two, anchor step, and tap, and tap, and tap, and tap. Basic forward and back, and a paddle, and a paddle, and a paddle, and a close. One and two, this is wall three, and five, six, seven, and eight. One and two, three and four, five and six, full turn. One and two, three and four, back to the beginning after the turn. One and two, three and four, five, six. I don't know where I was. Turn. One and two, three and four, five, six, seven, part two. One and two, three and four, go to folders. Okay, so after our restart on, sorry, after our little change, we start again back into the full routine. I messed you up. I hope I won't mess you up with the music. All right, and the rest of the dance is just back to the basic, okay? So let's do it. The dance is called, let me just tell you, Cancion Bonita by Unai Pino. And the music is Carlos Vives and Ricky Martin. Nice. Here we go. Brand new dance. A lot of fun.
Tengo en una libreta tantas canciones. Tiene tu nombre y tengo razones para buscarte y volverte a hablar.
Dice esa libreta sin más razones. Claro, ya pecha en dos corazones. Y dice calle San Sebastián.
Y si tengo que escoger,
me quedo contigo.
Si yo vuelvo a San Juan,
yo vengo contigo.
Y si te tengo que olvidar, tú sabes que no va a pasar. Y si te vuelvo a ver,
contigo desde acá Buenos Aires, contigo desde Londres hasta Nueva York, maldito castigo le grito al aire, si yo sé que contigo siempre estoy mejor.
Tengo en mi libreta esa canción boricua, esa que escribí pensando en tu boquita, y yo quiero bailar bien apretadita, rica con carita, cosita rica.
Tengo en mi libreta esa canción bonita, la que siempre, siempre fue tu favorita, la que siempre, siempre mueve tu boquita.
Y si tengo que escoger,
me quedo contigo.
Si yo vuelvo a San Juan,
yo vengo contigo.
Y si te tengo que olvidar, tú sabes que no va a pasar. Y si te vuelvo a ver,
me quedo contigo.
Guardo en una libreta de direcciones tu nombre escrito y unas canciones, y siento ganas de irte a buscar.
Oh. Dice en esa libreta sin más razones, la hora y la fecha y dos corazones, y dice calle San Sebastián.
Y si tengo que escoger, me quedo contigo.
Y si yo vuelvo a San Juan,
yo bailo contigo.
Y si te tengo que olvidar,
me quedo contigo.
Fabulous. Okay. All right. That was fun. We have 5 minutes left. We have, I hope you like that dance. I loved it. It was not too fast. It felt slow, didn't it? After the other ones. All right, let's go back to the first one. Now, let's do that one again. Should we do that one again? Or the bachata? Any requests? All right, no requests. All right, so I get to decide. Let's do the bachata one more time, okay? The others I'll put on. Oops, wrong one. The others I'll put on its own video. You can practice those during the week. Here we go, bachata.
Ay, madam. Es que tengo que ver tu nombre, mi amor.
Quiero citar, citar a mi par. Supongo una ropa, palabras con mi boca. Me habituaré a volar, un poco más allá. No quiero estar tranquilo. Es mi situación, tengo nada de corazón. Supongo un lamento boliviano que un día empezó. No va a terminar, porque ya nadie hace daño.
The other ones on their own right now, and you can practice them all week. Don't forget, if you're able, to sign up for our August the 5th in the park. We're going to dance under the pavilion, rain or shine, 10:30 in the morning. It's a Thursday morning. Hopefully, that signifies the beginning of being back in class. So let's keep our fingers crossed that things start to improve, and in August, we'll be back to regular. So have a wonderful week. Thank you for watching. Thank you for dancing along. Hope you have a great week. Enjoy your family, okay? And enjoy everything. Thank you.